What's up, folks? Matt again, representing the Maya Learning Channel. So, previously I did a couple of videos about retopology in Maya that proved to be pretty popular. But in case you forgot, or just haven't had a chance to see them yet, retopology is the process of simplifying a mesh with undesirable edge flow. That could mean turning tries into quads, optimizing a messy mesh for good deformation during animation, or even just reducing or increasing the number of faces. As you can imagine, doing this by hand used to be a pretty tedious task, and believe me, back in the day people used to actually do it this way. But luckily nowadays we have automated tools to help us, which is where Maya's Retopology tool comes in. Now, this tool, when tuned correctly, can give some fantastic results, but there was always one little problem with it. Notice that while I'm retopologizing this mesh, I can't do anything else. Maya has essentially locked me out because it's using all its resources to tackle this complicated retopo problem I've thrown at it. For some bigger meshes, with hundreds of thousands or even millions of polys, this often meant going to get a coffee, reading a book, mowing the lawn, basically time lost not working. Well, not anymore. In Maya 2025.1, we introduced Flow Retopology, which is the same great retopo algorithm you already know, except now running on the cloud. This means I can now punt my retopo task to the remote flow graph engine, which is frankly probably more powerful than my home laptop anyway, and continue to work while it does the heavy lifting for me. This also means I can run multiple retopo processes all at the same time without impacting the performance of my working scene. So this all sounds really great, but you might ask yourself, how do I get Flow Retopology? So here I am in Maya 2025.1, and I'm looking around and I don't see any Flow Retopology option anywhere. Here's regular retopology, but that's not what I'm looking for. So the reason it's not here is that Flow Retopology is a separate plugin. This allows us to update it independently of a big Maya release. To get it, just go to manage.autodesk.com and you'll find it under Maya Extensions. Just make sure to set your OS properly and then download and run the installer. Once you do that, then you can go into the plugin manager inside of Maya and enable the Flow Retopology plugin, which gets you this new Flow Graph Engine menu up here. Now, suppose I wanted to animate this bust. Obviously, the current topology won't skin very well, so let's fix that. I'll select my mesh and go to Flow Graph Engine, create new retopo job. This opens a retopo dialog that is pretty similar to Maya's base retopo feature, with a couple of notable differences. I always recommend setting the job name to something semi-specific, just to help with identifying what the intent was. For the output location, I'm going to choose a folder on my hard drive where I want to download the results once Flow Retopo is done. For the target face count, I can use the current face count up here as reference. I think I'd like to pare this down a bit since it's a bit too high res for my usage. As for the rest of the options, I'll leave them at their defaults for now, but you can try my interactive tutorial on retopology to learn what they do, or consult the very detailed documentation. For now, I'm just going to hit submit. And that's it! As you can see by this status message here, the job has been successfully sent to the Flow server. And as you can see, the Maya window is still fully interactive. I can continue with my work, perhaps by laying out my joints to prepare this bust for rigging. But how will I know when my retopoed mesh is done? For that, you can check out the Flow Job or Web Monitor. I recommend the Job Monitor when working in Maya for reasons you'll see in a moment. So in here, you can see the status of any jobs you have on the go. Right now, my bust job is scheduled, but after a bit of time, you'll see that the status changes to computing. If I select the job itself, I can see details like where the files will go, what the job started, the job ID, computation time and memory usage, and a summary of the various retopology settings I used. There's also a handy log here in case something goes wrong, or if you want to see what's going on in the graph engine. And once the job is complete, you'll get this little import button, which you won't find in the web monitor. So now if I click that, Maya will import the new geometry into the scene. And you can view the results side by side with the original. That's not bad, considering I didn't tweak any settings at all. Sure, we've got some loss of detail in the translation, but nothing overly worrisome. But here's the other advantage of retopologizing remotely. I can try a bunch of experiments with a bunch of different settings all at the same time without having to wait between each one. So for example, maybe I want to see what some lower poly retopos look like. Then maybe I want to try some different settings to modify my edge flow. Or maybe I want to really fine-tune topology by guiding it with some specific hard edges. And finally, I want to enforce symmetry on my result mesh to make it easier to skin later. I can run as many of these experiments as I want in parallel, again, without incurring any performance loss on my end. And they don't all have to be on the same set of geometry either. This is really handy when I have a model made up of multiple pieces that all need to be retopologized individually. You can perform up to 30 of these jobs in a calendar month. So in the end, the best result I got was by preserving some hard edges around the eyes and mouth, as well as going with some relatively high regularity and uniformity values. This job took about 6.5 minutes to complete. Not an eternity by any stretch, but also not an amount of time I'd want to be stuck waiting around either. And then if you consider all the experiments I was able to do in parallel, instead of having to wait for each of them one by one, the time saved adds up exponentially. And as you can see, the unedited final result already does a great job of deforming on my facial rig. So that about does it for Flow Retopology. If you have access to Maya 2025.1 or later, I highly recommend giving this feature a spin and letting me know what you think in the comments down below. And as always, be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.